Hello, Nancy here from Loombitious. Today we will be making the wolf bracelet. Ain't he funny? Well, first I want to explain something and thank someone. My designs are based on another loom designer. Her name is Courtney Cole from How to Loom Your Dragon. You should definitely check out her channel and do all the designs she has made. They're wonderful, complex designs and so fun to do. I did almost all her dragons, and she's the one that inspired me to design on my own. So thank you for that, Courtney. If you are listening, I don't know. I don't think you have time to listen, but well, continue your designs. I love them, and I might do another one in between my own designs. They're really fun to do, so make sure you check out her channel, How to Loom Your Dragon. Courtney Nicole is a wonderful designer, so make sure you do. We will be making the bracelet now. I'm going to start with the head. I'm going to make the ears. I'm using gray, so take your gray bands or another color if you want your wolf to be another color. Going to start with his ears. Take three gray bands, put them there. The rest of the ear is actually all double looped. So take a double loop gray, put them there, and another double looped here, and another. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, and another double looped there. Also a double looped gray going that way, and a double looped gray going this way. Double looped. Another double looped. And we need to overstretch a double looped from here to there. And on the opposite side as well. Like this. Now we need to cap off the bottom with a single gray band wrapped around four times. Like that. Also take two white bands. We don't need them just now. I will show you when you do need them. The horizontal bands. Also, a double looped gray from here to there. And another one from here to there. I believe that's it. Yeah, ready to loom. So I'll turn my loom. First, go behind the cap band. Grab those double loop bands. You have to loom carefully. If they do snap, you have to replace them. Like that. I go through the middle. Loom once more. Stop there. Now take your white band, wrap that around your hook four times. This might seem a little bit odd, but lift up those double loop gray bands and slide over the white band like this. Now we loom up the sides first. First do this one. That one. We have to do that again. So don't forget this one. Loom over. Take another white band, wrap that around your hook 4 times. Oh, you have to do the same. Lift up those two, slide over. And replace those bands. Now all we have to do is loom the last 3. Over. This will be one ear. Take it off very carefully. If one of those bands snaps, you will have to do the whole ear again. There it is. This will be one ear. You will have to make a second one. I already did, of course. So put it aside. You make the second one. And I will be showing you how to make some tufts first before we're going to make the head. Grab your white bands. You will need to make 4 of those. I will only show you how to do one. Just take 2 white bands and cap those off 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Just loom this. You have to make 4 of those. Put it aside. So 4 of those white tufts. They're very tiny. We also have to make 4 of those same tufts, but in gray. So take 2 gray bands. Cap off with 1 single band looped around 3 times. Loom. So you need 4 of those. I store them on a huge, well, toothpick. That are those. Then we need more gray. Put on 2 gray. 2 gray again. Cap those off, looped around 3 times with a single gray. Loom this one. Also need 4 of those. Take off. Ooh. Also store those. Come on. It doesn't want to come off. There we go. Also need 4 of those. And the last set of 4. You need 3 gray bands. Two gray. Let me check. And also need to cap off with a single gray looped around 3 times, like this. Loom those. Put them aside. So also 4 of those. 4 big tufts, 4 medium tufts in gray, 4 small tufts in gray, and 4 small tufts in white. Now we will be doing the top of the head with the ears on. So take your ears and follow me. 2 gray bands. There. Two in the middle. 2 more. Two here. 2 there. 2 going this way. 2 going that way. As you can see, it's very similar to my fox head design. We need to cap off 4 times. 4. I learned this from Courtney. 2 horizontal bands, also 2 bands. You need to create a triangle. Also do that there. Now we have, no, we don't. First we start to loom. So follow me. First loom over these. Go back into your cap band and loom over those. You can loom up the middle row. Don't need to put anything there. And loom up the sides once, because we have to place the ears. Take an ear. Well, you can see there is some white inside the ear. You will have to put on the ear with the white facing down. So, place one ear on this peg. Try to put it on without twisted bands. Sometimes that's hard to do so. And the other ear, also the white facing down on that peg. Push down if you need to. If it wants to come off, simply push down. Now loom the last bands. Make sure you go behind all the bands and don't loom your horizontal band like this. Now tie off the ends. You can do this with any color, it doesn't matter, but I won't use gray if I were you. Then it would be hard to see what you tied off. Now take this off carefully. This will be, you have to turn the ears a bit. This will be the top of the wolf's head with the ears. They're a bit different than I did. Well, I do like this better. So put it aside. We will need that later. Well, let's do the next part of his head. Also take 2 bands two gray. Going to do the middle row first, to there, to here, to here, to here. Now we need to take three gray bands, going here. Two more gray bands. Now take a gray and a white band. So a gray and a white. Put those there. And let me see. Two white bands. Yes, it's supposed to be like that. Now let's do the sides. Two gray. Two more. Two more. And two more. Now take your white bands to here, two more white, and now let's do the opposite side, two gray, two gray. Gray, two more gray, take two white, two white again. Now we have to make some, well, I could say hair, but another kind of tuft on the side of the face. Also a technique I learned from Courtney. I learned a lot from that girl. Take two white bands, wrap them around your hook three times, like that. Now take two white bands and pull those over. Then we need to place those bands here, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, place them there. We also have to do that on the opposite side. So take two white bands, wrap around your hook three times. Take two white bands and pull over. Place them on the opposite side. Here, like that. Now take two more white, going this way, and two more white going that way. Now we need to cap off the bottom with a single black band. Wrapped around four times. Let's count. One, two, three, four. And going to put on our horizontal bands. Take two white bands. Make a triangle like this. Take two more white bands. Make a triangle. Two more white. And two more. Now take your gray bands, make triangles, two bands all the time, like that. And the last two horizontal bands, actually the last one. Now I have to check something. Oh, I didn't write down how I did that. Well, it doesn't matter that much. We're going to put the tufts on the side. So take your small white tuft. And place that on the 5th peg from above. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Place that here. Also on the opposite side. The other two are for the bottom jaw. Place those there. Now take your smallest gray tufts. This one. Place that here. Another one for the opposite side. Take your medium tufts, so the one with two bands on top. Place that there. And another medium tuft on the other side, the opposite side. Oh. Place that here. Also try to put this on without any twists in the bands. Now take your large tufts. Actually, you have 6 loops. There. Place those here. And yet another one. These are the large tufts. Place that there. Now we will have to make the eyes. I will do blue eyes. You can do any color you want. You can also make yellow eyes if you want to. So take a single eye color band, wrap around 2 times. Take a single black, wrap around 4 times. Then take your first band and wrap around 2 times again. This will be the eye. We'll take a single gray band, double loop it. Now you need to pull over all those bands onto this double loop band. If they want to. This will be one eye. Let me check where to put it. 1, 2, 3, 4 on the 4th peg. I will turn my loom for this. 1, 2, 3, 4. You have to make sure the good part of the eye, not with the cross on the back, is facing to the nose. And you can turn it a bit. You have to place that there, turn it again. So from the 4th peg in the middle to the fourth on the side. So let's do that again. Take a single eye color band, wrap around two times. I'm taking a gray, no. A single black, wrap around four times. And grab your eye color band and wrap around two times. I take a single gray, double loop it, and pull over the eye bands. And you will have to place that eye on the opposite side. I have a feeling I'm doing this the wrong way, and I guess I am. I am doing this the wrong way. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, it's an easy fix, but I did this the wrong way. You simply have to lift them up, place them there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, that's it. This is the way they're supposed to be placed. Those are three bands. Yes. Well, we're ready to loom. I'm sorry for the eyes. I did that the wrong way. Go behind the black bands, cap bands. Loom over the first two white. Loom over the next two. Now, to the middle row, those are three bands you are looming now. This can be a bit crowded here with bands. Simply push down a bit. We have to place the top of the head there. So now loom up the sides. Make sure you go behind the tufts and behind the cap band and loom over. Only grab the bottom two bands, loom over, and the next two. That's only one. I'll have to go and check from the side. Yes, got them both. Don't go any further, stop there. Also do the same thing on the opposite side. So go behind the tuff and the horizontal bands, grab the bottom two gray. Loom over, make sure you go behind all the bands. Push down a bit, stop there, don't go any further. Now take the top of your head. We have to place this in between the eyes. Upside down. So we have the ears facing up on one side. We'll have to place them facing down. Don't go through the cap band, but go through the first set of bands in the middle. Actually, if you just simply pull it, you will see a hole. Just put through your hook. And we need to place that in between the eyes. with the ears facing down. There are many bands there, so it can be a little hard to do so. You have to place it like this. Now you have to go into this pack and grab the bottom two gray bands. I'm turning my loom, otherwise I cannot see what I'm doing. Make sure you go behind the eye bands and grab the bottom two gray. So tight. I can't pull them through at once. Yes, got them. And loom over again. The next, stop there. Pull off the top of the head. Now you can see the ears are facing up the right way. We have to attach those three loose ends on these three pegs. Make sure you go through all the bands. Place those here. Loom over the last two. Now go into these four bands you tied off. Make sure you have all four of them. Place those here. Hard for me to see. What I'm doing here. Grab the bottom two gray, loom over. The same on the opposite side. Make sure you got all the bands you tied off. Put them around this bag. And loom over the final two gray bands, like this. Now we need to tie off those three ends. I will reuse the bands I tied off the top head with. Take them off. You don't have to take them off. You can also use new bands to tie off those ends. We can hardly see the knot here. Come on. Yay, got it. Tie off those four bands. Well, there are two bands, but now you can take them off carefully. So here comes the funny part. I always love this. You pull it off like it's coming to life or something. I don't know, but it's funny. Oh, I believe it's funny. Come, give back my hook. Yeah. Yay. sake of the last bands. Oh gosh. Well, this is funny. Look at it. Ah, cool. Well, mold it until you think it's okay. Push out the eyes. Squash his mouth, his nose. Give him your own makeover. Well, this will be the top of the wolf head. You can pull out the tufts a bit if you want to. Turn the ears. It's adorable. Well, let's make the bottom jaw. Take two gray bands, two more. I have a new camera. I hope you guys can notice that. I hope it's more clear to see what I'm doing. 1, 2, 3, 4 times. Oh, my design is so far away. 1, 2, 3, 4. Those are all two gray bands. Also on the opposite side. Oh, these are stretched. Two here. Two there. Here, two there, now let's do the middle row, also with two gray, two here, two there, two here. Two more. Now take your white bands, two at a time. I'll do the middle row first. Two bands, two bands, and two more. 1, 2, 3. Yes. More white. Take two white bands, place them there. Two more. On the opposite side. Let me see. Well, take one wide band, double loop it, place them there, and on the opposite side, double loop white. Twist so easily. And let me see. Now take two white, place them there, and two more white there. Cap off the bottom with a white band four times. A single band wrapped around four times. Now we're going to do the horizontal bands. Double loop a single white and make a triangle. Double loop another single white. Make a triangle. Push down a bit. Let me see. Now take two white, place them there. No, take gray, two gray bands, make another triangle, two more gray, the last two. Now we have to make the tongue. I'm using pink. Double loop a single pink. double loop another. And another one. And we need to cap off that one 4 times with a single pink. 1, 2, 3, 4. So those are 3 double loop pinks. I have to loom this. You can leave it there. We will be attaching it when we need it. But that will be his tongue. We need to place the tufts. So grab your small white tuft. Place those here. Another white tuft for the opposite side. This is actually the same as we did with the middle of the head. Take your small gray tufts. Place one there. And another one on the opposite side. Now take your medium tufts, so there are 4 loops around your hook. Place those there. And yet another middle sized tuft for the other side. Place that there. Now take your large tufts, so you will have 6 loops around your hook. Place those there. And then the last tuft on the opposite side. Now, make sure you got them all around the peg. Oh, I believe that's it. I hope I don't forget the tongue. No, I won't. So, we're ready to loom now. So, go behind the cap band and grab the first 2, not one. Where is it? Doing something wrong here. I grab my cap end. 2, 3, 4. Don't do that. That's why it's so important to go behind the cap end. Loom over the first 2. Loom over those. We're going to do the middle. Let me check. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Now take off your tongue. If it wants to. Here it is, and place that on this peg. Turn it like this, and loom up the middle row. Stop there, don't go any further. Now we're going to loom up the sides. Let me see, 2 times. So this is a double looped white, then 2 whites. Push down because we have to attach the head here. Now do the other side. A double loop white. Two white, push down a bit. Now take the top of your wolf's head. Go. I hope you can see this. Go through these two and these two bends. We need to stretch that out and place over this peg. Will be, well, you can manage. Then you have to go inside this peg and grab the bottom two gray bands. Pull them through and loom over. Well, loom up this row. Stop here. Push down. Now we have to do the other side of the head. So go through these two bands. Can you see this? I'll show to the camera. Grab those four bands. It's the same as the other side. Stretch out. Put them over. And now loom those two gray bands. Make sure you go behind all the bands on that peg. And loom over. Also loom up this row. Stop there. Now we need to attach those three ends to those three pegs. So I will have to take the head off, the bottom jaw off a bit. Otherwise it will stretch too far. So take the head off. Will be enough. Yes. So go through the four bands. Well, actually two bands you tied off, but there are four loops. Put them over this peg. Now go through these four bands. Well, I'm not the ears are in the way. Put them over there. Well, first I'm going to loom. Will be the last set of two bands. Comes off very easily, so put them on and just loom up once more. The last two. Go through, put them around this peg. Oh, my tips are in the way. Come on. Yes. Now those last two bands. Make sure you go behind the tuff and grab the bottom two gray. Doing that the wrong way now, I guess. I have three. How is that possible? There are only two there. Ah. It was my horizontal band. Guys, I have to turn my loom. I can't see this. You have to grab the bottom two gray bands and loom them over. Sorry, it's off screen. I really can't see what I'm doing here. Yes, I got them. Whew. I hope yours will be easier to grab. I'm taking off my tying mints again. Ah, well, now you can see I did this wrong. There's one coming off. That ain't a good thing. So I will have to put that over again. Oh gosh, I really have a problem here. I can only see one. Is there still one on? Yeah, there's still one on. So I need to fix this. You go and take off the head. This is actually why I like to pull off the tying bands before. Come on. Simply need to get over those. Yeah, got them now. And this way you can check yourself. I did it wrong. No, it's okay. You better can find it out now than when you are pulling this off, when you got your head finished. Phew. I have a very high heart rate right now. But it turned out okay. So tie off all these ends. You probably already have your head in your hands. Well, I'm taking it off right now. Do this very carefully with all the tufts on the sides. Hard one. And take off the last three. So this will be your completed wolf head. You will have to pull out the tufts, especially the white one. Otherwise you can't even see it. It's in between, but you can pull those out. Like this. You will have to mold him. Until you are pleased with your head. So there we have our wolf head. Now we will be making the bracelet. Well, actually, no. I will be making his tail first. So, let's do that. Isn't he cute? With his little tongue, you can pull that out too. A bit. There it is. Oh, he is adorable. I like him. Yeah. I do. Well, put it aside. We're going to do his tail. First, grab three gray bands, place them here. Are these? No, there. Now take two gray, go down, two more gray. And two more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We need to go down 6 times with 2 gray bands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes. 1, 2, 3. two gray bands there, two gray bands here. The last two gray on this side, there. Now we have to take two white bands, two there, two here. Now we're going to do the opposite side. Take two gray, go this way, two gray, two more gray, two gray, two gray. And two more gray. Now grab two white bands, go down three times, two more white, two more, yes, can you see this? Go diagonally like this. I kept off this peg. You can hardly see this because of the light. Kept off this peg with a single white wrapped around four times. Four. Now we have to place the horizontal bands. They're all double loop bands. Take a double looped white. Put that there. Take another double looped white, put that here. Now we're going to do double looped gray until you reach the top of the tail. That's one. Double looped gray there. Double looped gray here. Double looped gray. And another double looped gray. And now you're ready to loom. So go behind the cap band. First loom over those two. And those two. Loom up this row first. And loom over those. Now go to the bottom and loom up this entire row. And those are the last three bands. Now you can take off your tail. It's actually a bit shorter than the foxtail, but similar to the foxtail. So this will be the tail on your wolf bracelet. Pull a bit. You can put it aside now. We don't need it just yet. We'll need that later. This is the final time I'm going to explain how to make your bracelet adjustable. I will be making another video with just an explanation how to make your bracelet adjustable, because Well, I think it's kind of annoying. I need to explain all the time how to do that. And if you already did the bear bracelet and the fox bracelet with me, you already know what I'm going to say. So I will make a separate video on how to make your bracelet adjustable and refer to that video if you want to know how to do that. So here it goes. I need to grab another bracelet. See, yes. I will use my fox bracelet to show you how to make it adjustable. I already know the size of my own wrist, so I already know how long my legs need to be for the bracelet to fit. If you also know you will be using this technique, if you know your size. But there is a way to make your bracelet adjustable after you loomed your bracelet, and I will show you that right now. Obviously, if you don't use the already made legs, there will be nothing here in the corner of your bracelet. So I will show you how to make the leg after you loomed your bracelet. You go through the bends on the corner. This isn't a corner because there is a leg, but you go through those two bends, four loops, and you take two bends and simply pull those through and reclaim on your hook. You have to do that. Well, I don't know the size of your wrist, obviously, so you have to do this until you reach the right size so it can fit. This way, if it's too long, you can simply take off two bends and attach an S-clip. Like this. And then you simply attach an S-clip. And you have to do this on every corner of the bracelet. And you can make it in any size you want that way. I won't be doing this. I will be making legs. And also will show you how to do that. So there is my loom. So take two gray. Two more. Two more gray. Two more. I believe five times. One, two, three, four, five. Yes. And another two. Then take two white bands. Place them there. And cap those off with a single white looped around three times. And then simply loom up, go behind the cap band, and loom up your leg. You will have to make four of those. I already did. So these are the legs I'm going to put on each corner of the bracelet. So now you will have to set up your loom in a rectangular shape with one, two, three, four, five rows. You can do six if you want, but I think that's too big. You can also do three, but that is, well, you will get a very tiny bracelet the way and the head is quite big, so it will look a bit strange. But it can be done with one loom. Only the bracelet will be smaller. Well, let's grab a lot of gray bands for this, because we have to fill our whole loom. First, we go up with two bands at a time. So take two gray and go up. Now we simply have to fill all the rows with two gray bands. Too bad I can't sing. I won't do that. Or you will have to shut off your audio. No, I can't sing. But I can loom. Simply put on two bands at a time. Gray for me. I don't know if you're doing a white wolf. You use white. Now go down the second row. All to the bottom with two bands. To be honest, it's more fun to do a whole animal for me. Don't know how you guys think about that, but I will do my cow design. It ain't a calf. It's an adult cow in a small version. But I will do a tutorial on that. I think I will do that next, after I did this bracelet. Still go down. This happened to me so many times. Here, a new pack of bands. One snapped already. Doesn't matter. I have a lot more. Now go down the third row. All with two bands. Two more. Two more gray. The fourth row, just fill it up with two bands at a time. I'm actually quite happy with my new camera. I can record longer than an hour, so I don't have to stop and hit the record button again. More. Two more. The last row, also two bands all the time. Two more gray, two more, two more gray. Now we have to go up this row. So take two gray here, two gray there, to here, to there. And we're going to do the horizontal bands. Also two gray bands at a time, stretched out over all five pegs. Make sure your loom won't collapse. Simply stretch them out. We'll make your bracelet very tight. These are also two gray bands. This will be the last. Now, if you are making your bracelets adjustable, that means you will do the legs after you loom the bracelet, you will need to cap off this corner with a single gray looped around three times, and you will have to make your leg in that cap band and just the other corners. I will be using my already made legs that will function as a cap band for me. So I will place those on every corner. That's one. And one here, of course. And on the other side. That. Now grab your tail. That will be placed on the, well, the seventh peg, I thought. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes, the seventh peg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is the middle of your loom. So place your tail over that peg. If you want to, well, the tail is a bit thicker here. If you want to face that the other way, just flip it. Put it on the other way. Now take your head. Oh gosh, my loom already is collapsing, I see. How can that be? Let me see if I have another. No, I don't. Let me see if I can fix this now. I hope I can. That's what I mean by collapsing. It won't fit there. And then I have to place it there. Look, it won't even fit now. Yes. Well, it will have to be like this, I guess. Well, take your head again. You can see you attach your tail on the seventh peg. The middle two, well, four loops, you have to put on the opposite side of the tail. Make sure you got all four of them. I do now. And attach that across the tail. I will take off those tying bands. To make sure I have all of them around that peg. I'll simply attach those next to the pegs. The pegs next to the middle. Those there. Those will go there. So this will be your head and your tail. We are going to start, you have to face the head right side up, but you guys can see that. We're going to start in this corner. You could have a cap in there. I have a leg. We're going to loom the first two to the side. So go behind your cap band or your leg. Take the top two and loom over sideways. Take the top two and loom over sideways. Go behind all the bands. Take the top two and loom sideways. And again. Oh gosh, my loom is curving in. Really annoying, but I will have to do. Now simply loom up the entire row, all the rows. Just make sure you go behind your leg or cap band and behind the horizontal bands. Loom up. Try to do this without too many twisted bands. It will look way nicer. This can be kind of hard. Just go behind all the bands, take the bottom two and loom over. Go in, take the bottom two, loom over. Again. And simply loom up the entire row. Don't go across yet. We have to do that as last. Loom up this row. I'm simply looming up, so if you can see, I'm just looming up the entire row and then go down and loom the next. So I'm not doing anything special, just looming. Looming. Courtney Nicole will be doing a whole wolf, so I'm really excited about that. So you should check out how she did a whole wolf. She hasn't done them yet, but she will. So I will definitely look at her design and maybe even make it. Simply loom up, don't do anything yet on the top. Is that okay? Yes, go behind all the bands here. There are actually 8 bands you need to go. Or 8 loops, not 8 bands, 4 bands. Loom up. Okay, you see my loom is curving up. Oh. Mm. So I guess someone is having a party. I guess you guys can't hear the music, but I can. Go behind all the bands on the till, I'll loom over. I'll go up this entire row. Now go back to this corner. Go behind your leg or nothing and loom over those. Go behind all the bands, loom over sideways. This one. And the final two bands. Yay! You did it! We have to tie off this corner, but there are a lot of bends on that peg, so I suggest you use two body color bends to tie this off. You can hide these bends inside the bracelet later. First you need to secure those bends so it won't fall apart. Simply pull, not too tight, don't pull too tight. Well, I'm going to hide those bends. Now take him off and your bracelet will be done. Well, I need to attach two S-clips. I'm saying that so very Dutch, S-clips. Well, I can't do anything about that. Maybe I can teach you guys some Dutch words when I'm doing tutorials. Would you like that? Nah, I don't think so. What words would I be teaching you? I have no idea. Yeah, I can teach you wolf in Dutch. Wolf is wolf. Not that different, but shall I teach you the word bracelet? That will be funny. Maybe you can all teach you Dutch so I can do my tutorials in Dutch. Bracelet is armband. That's totally different. It's weird for me to talk Dutch now. If you would like to hear other words in Dutch, you desperately want to know, you can ask. You can also request another animal. I think the next tutorial will be my cow. I use a lot of techniques from Courtney Nicole to make the cow, but I love how it looks, and I guess you guys also. Oh my gosh, did I forget? Oh no, I thought I forgot to loom one set of bands there. It's okay. I'll take it off. No, I think I will do my cow next. Take off the last, not the row, the bands. Yay! Oh gosh, also looks very, very, very funny. I haven't seen this yet as a completed bracelet. And now I can. Oh, he looks cute. The tail. Oh, really adorable. Well, anyway, we have to hide those two bands sticking out there. This side of the bracelet will be on your wrist, so we are going to pull through those two tying bands on this side, so you won't see it. Pull through some bands, it doesn't matter what bands, you won't be able to see it anyway. Simply pull through, well, all the bands you want to pull it through, it doesn't matter. And there he is. Well, I had someone writing down a comment on a picture. It looks like a rug or a carpet, actually. Well, here is my wolf carpet. I love him. My wolf rug. Take an S clip. You need two of them. Put those around kippens or four loose bands if you made your bracelet adjustable. Let me grab another. Yay, all three of them. So the final three bands, put it around and, well, and slide them over your wrist. Oh gosh, really? Oh, this looks wonderful. There he is. Oh, it looks nice. I hope you guys also enjoyed this tutorial. And I also hope you will join my next tutorial. The next will be the whole cow, so the whole animal, not a bracelet. I also will be doing a cow bracelet. The bracelet cow will have quite large head, and the whole cow I will be doing is a small version of the adult cow. So that head would be a lot smaller and too small to fit the bracelet so well. I will have to do another tutorial for the big cow head and turn that one into a bracelet. But it's my favorite animal, so I would love to see it as a whole cow and as a bracelet. Well, this is your wolf. Be careful. He might start to cry. I hope you enjoy this. Would be fun. I would love to see you guys post pictures of your made creations. It would be very funny for me, especially if you've done it in a different color or maybe adjusted the design yourself. I would love to see how you guys do that. So post pictures on my page and, well, like, subscribe to my channel. And I will hope to see you guys next time. Thank you. Have a good night. Bye bye.